tight, but I can squeeze through.
Hold for identity scan.
One of these again.
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
Dr. Sobek, you are 355,510 days out of date for your meeting with Mr. Farrell. Please proceed to the 35th floor.
Wait. 350,000? That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on? Or a statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill. And they honored it?
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today. With over 25,000 human employees based in nations and corporate holdings across the globe, Feral leads the world in every sector of self-sustaining...
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people, not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your focus. They'll help you understand.
Smell to it, not even old death. Another cave-in. But I could get through.
Thank you.
I'll bet I can use that as a ramp to get back up. Like the way up. What's left of it? Gonna be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobeck. If plants can find a way to hang on up here, guess I can too. I'd have to ditch something. Let myself stiffen up. Handholds. All right, made it. Wonder what we'll find.
data has been erased from this device. Do you wish to deploy Alpha privileges to recover purged data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
A file has been recovered.
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
Your killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes, those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobek here, but they hated each other.
Another cell has been recovered.
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final cell has been recovered.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I am speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
Her solution is so terrible. What did she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the Old Ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that feral robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Sylens, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
All right, Sylens, you've made your point. I came to these ruins hoping to learn more about this Elizabeth Sobek. And I have, but I still don't understand my connection to her. Or why the Eclipse is trying to kill me. Or who Hades is. No answers, just one question after another.
Exactly. Which is why it's time to expand your frame of inquiry. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobek.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that feral robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Not so fast, Sylens. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobek could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly. An ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation. Wasting time.
Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asuram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved. Well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up there, at least. U.S. Robot Command next. To learn the secrets of Zero Dawn. easier when I was a kid.
Charger's ready to run!
They're inside too.
Log. First battle of the Eastern Seaboard Wall. Had a long run up to it. This was before Kalmar, and projections were a lot worse for the East. For 3 weeks, we kept getting scrambled out to some coastal burg to train Minutemen. It was always raining on account of Europe already being torched. Block after block of prefab barracks. They were still printing barracks right up until the hour the main force hit. The Minutemen? We ran combat drills with them in the streets where they'd lived.
haven't seen one of these since I was a little kid. There must be some kind of code. Maybe I should try scanning objects in this area. Useful information.
Hey, y'all wanted to know how I remember the geotherm system reboot? Goes like this. Bird flies north in summer, east in spring, west in fall, and south in winter. Didn't expect to hear nature poetry from the lips of Mike the GT Tech now, did you? As usual, I defy expectations.
I wonder what it's for.
Thank you. trying to get over on us. Can't save you now.
I'll take this. I'll tuck that away. Map of what?
Our world. The planet Earth, Aloy. It's not flat like you thought.
Why would I think that? During eclipses, the shadow cast on the moon is curved. So our world is a globe. And it looks like this, from a distance.
We'll discuss this another time. Back to the matter at hand.
The Faro robots were spreading across the world, eating everything up. Somehow, Elizabeth stopped them before it was too late. But how? I can't spare the weight. Save these for the trail. The Eclipse. Tampering with a metal devil. They don't think they can wake it, do they?
Watch out!